This is a problem that combines the ideal gas law with Raoult's law. We have gas mixture, it's 85 mole percent N2 in the balance N. Hexane flows through a pipe at a rate of 100 meters cubed per hour. The pressure is 2 atmosphere absolute, the temperature is 100 degrees C. We need the molar flow rate of the gas in kilomoles per hour. We need to find out if the gas is saturated, and if it isn't, what temperature would it have to be cooled to? And finally, to what temperature would the gas have to be cooled to at constant pressure in order to condense 80% of the hexane? So let's start with A. What is the molar flow rate of the gas in kilomoles per hour? And we are going to assume an ideal gas. The temperature is 100 degrees C, most of it is N2, and if we looked at RT over P, we would find that it was greater than 5. So we're going to find our N equals PV over RT, which is 2 atmosphere times 100 meters cubed per hour divided by 0.08206 meters cubed atmosphere per kilomole Kelvin. And this is multiplied by, remember, it's 100 degrees C, but we have to put it in absolute temperature, 373 K. And that leaves us with 6.53 kilomoles per hour. The next thing we need to find out is if the gas is saturated. And what that means is, at saturation, the partial pressure of the gas has to equal the vapor pressure of the gas at that temperature. And in this case, it's the vapor pressure of our hexane at 100 degrees C. So we use Antoine's equation to find our vapor pressure of hexane at a temperature of 100 degrees, and that's 10. We look up to find out what the constants A, B, and C are. So that's 10 to the 6.87776 minus 1171.350 divided by our temperature, which is 100, plus 224.366. So our vapor pressure at 100 degrees is 1,845 millimeters of mercury. So now what we have to find out is what our partial pressure is and whether this equals 1,845. So our partial pressure of hexane is going to be the Y, the mole fraction of hexane, times the total pressure. And we're given, if you take a look back here, that the mole fraction is 0.15. So this equals 0.15 times the pressure, which is 2 atmosphere, and then we need to put it in millimeters of mercury. 1 atmosphere is 760 millimeters of mercury. So that equals 228 millimeters of mercury. So since the partial pressure is less than the vapor pressure, it is not saturated. So in order for it to be saturated, this 228 millimeters of mercury has to equal the partial pressure, which is 10 to the 6.87776 minus, again, the same 1171.350. But here we're solving for the temperature, so it's T plus 224.366. Again, this is the only way that the partial pressure, which is 228 millimeters of mercury, is going to equal the vapor pressure when we solve for that T. So we can write this as log 10 of 228 equals, and when we solve for T, what we find out is that T equals 34.8 degrees Celsius. In other words, that is the temperature that it would have to be cooled to in order for the hexane to start condensing. The next thing that we're asked is, to what temperature would the gas have to be cooled to at constant pressure in order to condense 80% of the hexane? So what we have to do here is do a picture. So here we have a system, the system we're talking about, with the unknowns indicated on the flowchart. So the first thing we can do is solve for our moles of liquid, because we know that our moles of liquid, and again, hexane is the only condensable species, so it's the only thing that's going to condense out. We know that it's 80% of the hexane that's in the feed. So the hexane is 50% or 15% of the feed. So 0.15 times 6.53 kilomoles per hour gives us the kilomoles of hexane that's in the feed, and 80% of that comes out of N sub L. So our N sub L is 0.7836 kilomoles per hour. Now we can do an overall balance. 6.53 has to equal L N sub L plus N sub V, so N sub V equals 5.746 kilomoles per hour. The next thing that we have to do is a hexane balance, because what we need to find out is, what is this Y right here? So we do a hexane balance, and we find that 0.15 times 6.53, which is coming in, equals that Y of hexane times 5.746, which is N sub V, plus our N sub L, which is pure hexane. So we solve for our Y, which is 0.03409. So what's that going to do? How's that going to help us? Remember, at the saturation point, the partial pressure of the hexane has to equal the vapor pressure of the hexane at that temperature, and we're trying to solve for that temperature. So what we're going to do is solve for the partial pressure. So our Y sub P equals 0.03409 times our pressure, which stayed constant, 2 times our 760 millimeters of mercury. So our Y sub P is going to equal 51.82 millimeters of mercury. And this is going to have to equal our vapor pressure at the temperature that we're looking at. So, again, our log 10 now of 51.82 equals, and when we solve for our temperature, we get 2.52 degrees C.